Hey, what's up, video editors? It's Premier Gal here, and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to create beautiful fluid ink transitions in Premiere Pro. To start, I got my ink fluid video from productioncrate.com. There you can search for ink fluids. There's a whole bunch to choose from. The ones without the stars are free, but the ones that have stars, you need to get a pro membership. Also, to give your video an extra overlay texture, you can use light leaks or flares from Production Crate as well. So download the ones that you like, and now let's head back to Premiere Pro and create some production magic. Here in my timeline, I have 6 stock videos I downloaded from Pond5. Now, over top of the video, I'm going to place a different ink fluid video from Production Crate. For some videos, I'll open it up first in the source panel and select specific in and out points from the clip and then drag it into the timeline. For the first ink bleed, I'm going to speed up the first part of the clip. So to do that, I'm going to expand the clip out and cut at the point I want to slow it down again. Then hit R to enable the rate stretch tool and then pull the clip inwards to speed up that portion of the clip. Then just select the other part of the clip and drag it over so it's flushed with the first portion of the clip. And then just cut it down so it matches the video clip duration beneath on video layer 1. You can of course also scale up and reposition any of these ink bleeds using the motion tools from the effects controls panel. So once we're done adding and adjusting the ink clips in the timeline, it's now time to add the luma key effect to reveal the video beneath. First, we're going to lasso and select all the ink bleed clips on video layer 2. Then go to effects and search for luma key, then drag and drop that effect on all the ink clips. Now you can see that the video blends in with the ink fluid. To make each transition smoother, let's apply a cross dissolve at each edit point in the timeline. First, I'm going to select an edit point, right click and select apply default transition, which is a cross dissolve. Then I'm going to customize the length of this transition by pulling the edge inwards to make it faster. And next I'm going to select that transition, hit Command C to copy it, and then I'm going to select the next edit point, hold Shift, and select all the other edit points in my timeline, including the edit points of the videos below. Then go up to Edit and select Paste, and now all the edit points we selected have the same cross dissolve. As a final touch, let's add a layer of purple light leaks above all video layers and change the blend mode to screen and reduce the opacity to 80% so it's not too intense. Then let's duplicate this light leak video by holding Alt Option until the leaks fulfill the entire duration of the video in the timeline. If you want to add text, you can do that too. Just select the light leak and ink layers and move it up to the layer above. And then on video layer 2, use the type tool to add text to the program monitor. Now the text will be revealed within the ink luma key. Now that we're done, let's hit return on the keyboard to render effects in the work area, and then we can play it back. So that's all for this video. If it helped you out, please give it a thumbs up. Hit the top button on the left to subscribe to my channel so you're notified when I make new tutorials. And below that, you can hit the Patreon button to support my channel so I can continue making awesome tutorials every week. Thanks again for watching, stay creative, and I'll see you all very soon.